Good evening to all of you all. We are now going to see general parameters of motion and how that reduces to a projectile, and then see what is meant by the envelope of a projectile. So we take a coordinate system x and y, let us say, and z also, and there is, let us say, a particle moving. This is the path of a particle, okay, and it is at some position P. The coordinates are x, y, z at time t, and this is the position vector r. So r is the instantaneous position vector. If you differentiate this, dr by dt gives the instantaneous velocity. If you differentiate this again, dv by dt, that gives you the acceleration, which is the instantaneous acceleration. So these are the general parameters of motion. Now when it comes to a projectile, in a projectile, a body which is projected into space on the surface of the earth, no other force we assume is acting other than the force of gravity. So therefore the acceleration is the downward acceleration g, 9.8 or approximated to 10. So A would be minus gj. If you assume j to be j vector, y axis to be the vertical, then minus gj. This ensures that it is a projectile. Special case for projectile. So this is the first equation for a projectile motion. So we can use the second dv. A is dv by dt, that is equal to minus gj. So we integrate this now. Integral dv, we can say, is integral gj dt, limits from 0 to t, initial velocity u to v. Initial velocity is u, and v is the instantaneous velocity. So I get v minus u is equal to minus gt j, or I get v equals u minus gt j. That is the velocity, instantaneous velocity. Now I can get the instantaneous position by using the idea that V is dr by dt. We know V is u minus gt j equal to dr by dt. Again integrate, integral u minus gt j dt equals to integral dr. Put the limits 0 to r, the particles initially at the origin, resuming, and the time is 0 to t. So integral u dt would be ut, and minus integral of t dt is t squared by 2, so you will get gt squared by 2 j, that will be equal to r. Yes, that is the, this will be the second equation, and this is the third equation. So let me write these equations on the top. So the first equation, before I clear it, A equals minus G J V equals U minus GT J and R equals UT minus half G T squared J. Now you can write all the components of each of these. So you A is, of course, A can be written as, and so this is basically you will have AX is 0, AY is minus GJ, AX is 0, AY is minus GJ, and AZ is 0. Similarly, you can write VX, we can write it as VXI plus VYJ plus VZK will be equal to, for U if I write, UXI plus UYJ plus UZK minus GTJ. So this will get combined here. And we will get Vx equal to Ux, that is independent of time, the x component of the velocity, and Vy would be Uy minus Gt, and Vz would be Uz, that is again it will not stand independent, only Vy is a function of time. For R, I can write it as Xi plus yj plus zk, that is equal to uxti plus uytj plus uztk minus half gt squared j. So here again j and j will combine, and we will have x is equal to uxt, y is equal to uyt minus half gt squared, and you will have z is equal to uz into t. Now we can assume that the projectile is projected in the xy plane. It is projected in the xy plane with a velocity u, and let's say this is theta. So if this is theta, the horizontal component would be u cos theta, this would be ux, and this would be uy, which is u sin theta. And obviously uz would be 0. So the equations will now reduce to Vx is equal to u cos theta, Vy is equal to u sin theta minus gt, Vz is equal to 0, Vz is equal to uz, uz equal to 0, and you will have x is equal to u cos theta, ux into t, ux is u cos theta into t, y will be u sin theta into t minus half gt squared, and z coordinate will be 0, because uz is 0. Yes? Now, this particle would take a certain trajectory. We all know from our earlier classes that this path is the path of the projectile is a parabola. How do we say that? Because the relation between the x coordinate and the y coordinate is quadratic. This is a quadratic equation between x and y. How do you figure that out? We need a relation between x and y. So we shall use this and this. We will eliminate t from the equation for y. T will be x by u cos theta. So y will be u sin theta into t. T is x by u cos theta minus half g t squared, that is x by u cos theta the whole square. So this will be u cancels here. I will get x tan theta minus g x squared by 2u squared cos squared theta. I can put it as secant squared theta. So this is the equation of the trajectory. Equation of the trajectory. Now you see this equation. In this equation, what are the variables? The variables are x and y. And the constants here, of course, g is a constant. Other than g, u is a constant and theta is a constant. And of course, g is a constant. Yes? Now, supposing there is a cannon mounted on top of a hill. The cannon mounted on top of a hill like that. This is the floor level. So here is the cannon. So I'll choose that as the origin and have this as the x-axis. And this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. Now, this cannon fires balls, cannon balls at the same speed u. So u, the speed of the cannon ball is constant. So u is constant. But it can vary theta. It can vary theta. So theta now becomes a variable. Okay. And now we are interested in knowing, see, supposing I take a certain fixed distance x. X is fixed. Fixed horizontal distance. At this horizontal distance, let us say there is an aircraft flying. Now we wish to know, this cannon, will it be able to strike the aircraft? The aircraft would also like to know whether it is flying in a safe zone or in a safe region. So, what we wish to find is that for a given x, x is given, that is it is constant. We would like to find out what is the maximum height, y max, which this is a variable. Maximum height, y max, which the cannonball can reach. So if the y max is something here, the plane is safe. But if the y max is something like this, then there is a danger of the plane getting hit. So how do we find out that? We use this very equation of the trajectory, but we know that x is a constant and theta is the variable here now. So we know when we want to find the maximum or the minima, we know we have to equate the first derivative to 0. So we will find out dy by d theta. Dy by d theta will be x is a constant, derivative of tan theta is secant squared theta minus g x squared by 2u squared, all these are constant. Derivative of secant squared theta will be 2 secant theta into secant theta tan theta. So this we can write it as x secant squared theta minus gx squared by 2u squared into 2 secant squared theta tan theta. This we shall equal to 0 for finding the maximum. So secant squared cancels, this 2 cancels, 1 x cancels, and I get 1 minus gx, 1 minus gx by u squared into tan theta equals 0. So I will have tan theta equals u squared by gx. Tan theta is equal to u squared by gx. Now we should substitute this. This gives maximum y. This value of theta gives maximum y. So I can say y max is equal to x into tan theta u squared by gx minus gx squared by 2u squared. Secant squared is 1 plus tan squared theta. So tan theta is u squared by gx. So tan squared is u power 4 by g squared x squared. So let's simplify this. X cancels here. You get u squared by g minus, I multiply it inside, gx squared by 2u squared minus gx squared into u power 4 by 2u squared g squared x squared. So that will be, if you simplify this, u squared, here this goes, x squared cancels, 1 g cancels, I get u squared by g minus gx squared by 2u squared minus u squared by 2g. Combine these two, I will get u squared by 2g minus gx squared by 2u squared. That is y max. This is the equation of the envelope. It is also a parabola. Equation of the envelope. Now let's draw this graph and try to analyze it. This graph, if we draw, I plot x versus y max, it's going to be a parabola. This point is where x is 0. So if you put x equal to 0, you get u squared by 2g. That's the case where the cannon is firing vertically upwards. So if it fires vertically upwards, the maximum height reached will be u squared by 2g. If you use the equation v squared is equal to u squared plus 2gh, yes, u squared minus 2gh, you get u squared by 2g, the kinematic equation. This is the case where y max is 0. When y max is 0, if you put y max as 0, see what happens. To get this point, if y max is 0, you get u squared by 2g minus gx squared by 2u squared equals 0. So if you do some, so this 2 will cancel and you will get x squared is equal to u power 4 by g squared, or x is equal to u squared by g. So this point is u squared by g. This is nothing but the maximum range. For a projectile, The range is maximum and theta is 45. You know the range of a projectile is u squared sine 2 theta for a ground-to-ground projectile is u squared sine 2 theta by g. So at theta equals 45, sine 90 is 1, you get u squared by g. So this is the case where the aircraft is at a distance equal to the horizontal maximum horizontal range. It is safe for the plane to in fact be grounded at this point. Even if it is grounded here, slightly away of course, even if it is slightly away from this point, there is no danger of being hit. Yes? Since we said this is some hill and this is the ground, the horizontal for us will be through the origin we have taken. The maximum range we took along the x-axis passing through the origin. Yeah. So the aircraft for points below the x-axis, the aircraft can fly at say this height for instance. It will not be hit. But if it is somewhere here, there is a chance of it being hit. Okay.
Thank you.